In this video, we're going to look at how we can determine the type of chemical reaction. So, in terms of general definitions of these, synthesis is when you have two smaller components that make a larger component. Usually, that's two elements making a compound. Decomposition is the opposite of synthesis, where a compound breaks down into some smaller pieces, sometimes even its constituent elements. Combustion reactions are pretty specific. It's when you have a hydrocarbon fuel, so literally carbon and hydrogen, reacting with oxygen to burn and produce carbon dioxide and water. Single replacement reactions are when an element is reacting with an ionic compound in solution and two of your ions are going to switch places. Double replacement reactions are when you have two ionic compound solutions that react and trade cations. And finally, there is another type called acid-base reactions, which is just a special type of double replacement where you have an acid react with a base to form an ionic compound and water. So the good news is if you have some reactants that are a little bit more complicated than that general understanding of the types of reactions, there's a reference sheet for that. So if you're looking at synthesis and decomposition especially, I mentioned synthesis A and decomposition B, but there are some other types as well. So it might be worth referring back to this section in the reference tables so that you can see if you have some other type of product forming that isn't as straightforward as you maybe originally thought. So particularly with decomposition, we're using the little letter M to signify a metal of any kind. So this is a metal attached to carbonate, a metal attached to bicarbonate, metals attached to hydroxide and metals attached to chlorate. So it's showing you that you are getting some different gases given off, and in this case, we're even making water. So it would be a good idea if it's not a super straightforward one where you have a simple binary compound to refer back to these sections and look at them a little bit more carefully. Single replacement, double replacement, and combustion reactions are a little bit more straightforward. So you probably don't necessarily have to refer to the reference packet for these. But just in case you need a little bit of help with identifying single replacement, keep in mind that you're looking for a three-piece kind of reaction. So a single element and then a compound, and you need to tell or determine which of those are going to switch places. So if it's a metal by itself, it's going to replace the metal in the compound. If it's a halogen by itself, it'll replace the halogen in the compound. And then specifically, if you're trying to figure out how a metal would replace hydrogen, this can help you a little bit with the how the hydrogen gas would be given off and then what your other product would be. In terms of double replacement reactions, here's the specification for acid-base neutralization, but generally you're forming a precipitate and you're using your solubility rules to determine what that is. More on that soon. Or if you are forming water, that's when it would be considered an acid-base neutralization reaction. Finally, for combustion reactions, hydrocarbon tends to refer to anything that contains hydrogen and carbon, but it is possible that you might have something containing hydrogen, carbon, and oxygen as a compound fuel, and you'll be reacting that with molecular oxygen or O2 to form CO2 and water if that undergoes complete combustion, which is the only kind we look at in honors chemistry. In short, I hope that helps you learn how to use your NCFE chemistry reference table a little bit better. Thanks for your time, and I hope that was helpful.